Right, okay, so I think we're ready to start the webinar. It's 1 o'clock, so let's get started. Hi, everybody. My name is Jonathan Brindley. Just to run through the agenda quickly, what we're trying to cover today. You can see that there's going to be an introduction to JBUAS, and we're going to follow that up with our presenters, Kristaps Brass from SPH Engineering, who leads the team for UgCS range of mission planning software. We also have Chris Marshall, who is an RAE and a user of UgCS. He's going to be able to provide us with some practical tips and some reasons why UgCS needs to be in the toolbox. Then we're going to finish off with some Q&A. And hopefully there'll be some good questions as part of that. We're also going to open up the poll. So poll should be open, actually should be open already. So you'll be able to get involved in that. And at the end of this of the webinar, there'll be a survey as well. So yeah, make sure that you complete that. It's all really important information going forward. Okay, so about JBUAS. A little bit about ourselves. So we're the official UK reseller for SPH Engineering in the UK, and we work very closely on not just for selling equipment, but also demonstrations and trials, and also getting involved in an R&D project. We are working and do work with a number of partners in the UK to develop and commercialize drone systems. And we have developed recently although we started out as a UK-based company, UK-focused company, we've now started to look further afield and had inquiries from further afield, including those in North Africa and Middle East, predominantly UXO and also methane. So we've had a few inquiries from Europe in regards to methane, and in particular the dairy industry, which seems to be a growing area for methane detection. At the bottom, you'll see that we do also retain close working relationships. Of course, we speak with UgCS every day. We also talk with the sensor technical teams from the OEMs, and a few of those are at the bottom. Some of you would have seen recently that we handshaked on an agreement with Sensis, which works really closely with UgCS, and we also with Workswell in terms of the fully radiometric thermal cameras, which we're really happy about. So that's about us. So in terms of the sort of software that we use for our integrated systems that we sell with UgCS, we really rely on the UgCS range of mission planning software. And there are three types. I'm sure Kristaps will go into this a little bit later in a lot more detail. But some of the integrated systems that I'm going to mention today, all of them actually, they all rely on using either UgCS Pro, UgCS Expert, or UgCS Enterprise. Depending on what your needs are, then you would have one of those three. But in any case, the integrated system integrated systems that use the sensors, they all rely heavily on the UgCS range or planning tools to make sure that the sensor is accurately getting data and that your mission is being planned out and automated correctly. So it's a really, really important and integral part of the integrated systems that we market in the UK on UgCS's behalf. So here are just a few of the systems that we do, and there are others, but in the main, just to cover them so that you're aware of what we do cover methane laser detection. So we've done a lot of work, for example, with the University of Manchester in the UK to develop that, and also working with major operators in the UK as well. So yeah, we've done quite a bit of work in that area. Metal detection, there is a lot of work that we're aware of at the moment with UgCS and other partners to bring that to the market. And we're certainly involved in projects at the moment that are looking at that as a solution for both, for UXO and for archaeology actually. GPR systems, we offer the full range of GPR systems for M300 and heavy lift drones as well. But GPR systems typically, we're looking in the ranges of 1 to 300 megahertz. We go all the way up to 1,000 megahertz for shorter wavelengths, and things like, for example, soil. And as you can see there, we are using the M300 on a lot of for a lot of the sensors. So I'm very, very much able to integrate with the drones that you're using. Bottom right-hand corner, those who follow JBUS on LinkedIn and myself, you will see that we've done a lot of work actually with Airbone Platforms and Chris as team, both from an archaeological perspective, but also been doing UXO projects and also helping companies with lots of other applications as well, including high voltage line detection. So there's many applications that the magnetometer can be used for. Also able to provide echo sounder systems, and we do two types of that. We do a single frequency for straight bathymetry, and we also do dual frequency for looking at layering beneath the sea, the surface of the sea. So seabed, should I say. Lastly, but not least, we also offer sonar system. This is a system that is able to visualize what's under the water, and it's very useful for inspecting structures and also for search and recovery as well. So it's something that we have been talking to the police about and have actually demonstrated to the police. So again, these are the kind of systems that we are able to bring to the table and work with our clients to make sure that they get the best out of the systems and it delivers what they need it to deliver. And if there is anything that you think we can help you, then please get in touch with us. So yeah, you're in safe hands. I mean, in regards to the sensor kits, it's a complete solution. I mean, we try and come at this from the perspective of being able to position our clients where they can literally go out and provide, you know, earn money and undertake commercial projects with the kit. So we are looking to provide planning software training, sensor training, kit setup and configuration, providing practical tips and limitations of the sensors enabling the clients to understand the flight parameters of flying the sensors. Also post-flight processing training. So things like PRISM 2, which comes with GPR, and there's some training on that and other sensors as well. So the training to cover all of the sensor range, basically. And something else which is really important to us is ongoing support through trials. So whether you look at methane or you're looking at magnetometry or GPR, one of our strong points has been able to come to the site with yourselves and support you through the initial trials to make sure that you're happy with the system before you take it out and onto a customer site. So it's lots of touch points, and it's really a complete service that we're offering. It's not just a case of what you call straight selling. So I said about demonstration and trials, we have and are able to offer European wide demonstrations and on request. We've got European demonstrations on right on the table at the moment, and we've done some in the past. So again, if there is from a demonstration and trial perspective, if there is a sense or an opportunity you think that we could get involved in, then please get in touch with us. We'll do our best to try and help you. So that takes me on nicely to sort of UGCS, the mission planning software side of this webinar, and introducing Kristaps and Chris. So Kristaps has been with SPH Engineering Agency since 2014. I've had a long relationship since I've been, so it's been 2 years talking to Kristaps about all kinds of things. I would say there's not much about UgCS and the software tools that that Chris doesn't know. So he's going to be giving us a half hour sort of, if you like, session on all about UgCS and the different types of UgCS mission planning software that you can have. So from pro, expert, up to enterprise. And then he'll hand over nicely to Chris Marshall, who has been flying for a very long time. He's one of the top, I think it's 40 RAE in the country, able to deliver certified drone courses in accordance with CAA, and also uses the UgCS planning tool for a lot of the surveys that his team does. So he's very familiar with the practical parts of the software and really where it punches in much more above the competition. And I think that's going to be really important for people to hear from Chris, what he's got, how he sees it, and how he sees it, the benefits, the more benefits to him, and where it adds value to his operation. So I'll hand you over to Kristaps Brass and his presentation.
All right. So thank you, Jonathan. So let me just quickly share my presentation, then let's start. Okay, so now you should be able to see the screen. So yeah, basically UgCS is a professional flight planning software for drones. And in fact, the name UgCS, or the abbreviation, it stands for Universal Ground Control Software. So initially, it actually kind of all started back in 2013. So the company itself is called SPH Engineering, and we have four main business lines, as you can see here. UgCS is actually the oldest one of these. So we basically started out with making this software for flight planning back in 2013, and then eventually other products developed within the company. One of them, as Jonathan, you mentioned, is UgCS integrated systems. But this presentation will be a bit more about the UgCS part itself, since I'm the product owner of that. And I'll basically talk to you about how we do flight planning and what actually makes UgCS so great that a lot of professional pilots around the world are choosing to use it instead of other flight planning solutions. But yeah, in addition to that, we have other business lines. So like I said, UgCS, then UgCS integrated systems. We also have drone show software, as well as we do custom consulting and development. So we're based in Riga in Latvia. So we have currently partners all over the world. We have wide network of resellers as well. And of course, we offer products for different industries. But then going into UgCS itself, in case some of you haven't yet seen the interface or how it looks like, so this is just a general screenshot so you can at least, you know, get an idea of how it looks like. So everything, at least how I usually explain it, everything on the right side, this is concerning drone control. So up here, you're going to have your drones you have connected. You can have multiple drones at the same time connected to the system. But in general, most pilots simply have a single drone at the same time. Below that, you see all the telemetry from the drone. And so here you have all the commands that you can send to the drone. Then everything that's here on the left side, this is concerning your route planning. So here you can see I have the photogrammetry tool selected. And then, of course, we offer a lot of other tools for flight planning. So you can do, for example, photogrammetry, you can do vertical inspections, you can do search and rescue missions, you can do corridor inspections, as well as also we have a tool set for planning LiDAR surveys. So everything here is in 3D. So you can think of it as you can have the whole globe in 3D. We're using SRTM4 terrain elevation data, normally combined with Google satellite imagery. But you can also choose different map providers. You can use your own elevation. You can use even your own maps that you create. And one of the main features why people are choosing to use our software is the fact that we offer one of the best terrain following systems. So here also you can see that the drone is following the terrain currently. Basically all the flights that you do with UgCS, they are with terrain following, unless of course you choose to follow the terrain, unless of course you choose to use AMSL altitude. I think then now maybe let's go a bit further. So these are again, just like the steps are the points why pilots are choosing to use UgCS. So first one is the fact that, like I mentioned, you do all the flight planning in 3D, and there you're able to create these really complex plans, which, for instance, if you wanted to try to create the same plan on a mobile tablet, firstly, that planning would be in 2D, not in 3D. Plus, you wouldn't have as much detail and as many possibilities of doing that. In fact, the whole UgCS, it's built on top of a gaming engine, allowing you to plan the flights. So I think that's also really interesting fun fact that I suppose not many people might know about. So you can prepare all the flights before you go out in the field. So you do all the flight preparation in the office, typically, but you can also, of course, plan your flights while you are in the field. Because one of the things we offer is we offer you the possibility to catch maps as well as elevation of large areas. So up to 100 square kilometers per area, you can catch this for offline use, and then you can be in the middle of nowhere. And even without an internet connection, you will be able to plan your missions, to have your maps, elevation, and be able to fly your drone and collect the data that you need. Also, like I mentioned, you can create your flight plans according to custom digital elevation or digital surface models. You can import your own models as GeoTIFF files, so .tif extension. And similarly, also, you can import custom map overlays. We support not only DJI drones, we support others as well. I know specifically in the US, there's currently a higher demand for non-DJI drones for government projects. So like I said, UgCS is universal. So we support not only DJI, but drones from other manufacturers as well. And so all the routes, they can also actually be created. The most basic way is you simply press on the map and you put the points, the approximating points of a certain route segment. But alternatively, you can also create the routes if you already have a ready-made KML or CSV file. You can create them from that. If you have a KML file, well, let's say just the borders of some area, you can import that, and then you'll be able to see the borders on the UgCS map and be able to do your flight planning according to the borders. For LiDAR flights, we also have LiDAR toolset. The software architecture is also quite modular, and this I'll get in just a bit. And also with some licenses such as UgCS Enterprise, we also offer live video streaming from your drone. So you'll be able to see live video on drones on your laptop coming from the drone. Additionally, what you can see actually here in this screenshot is you are able to fly these vertical inspection missions. So you can fly not only horizontal turn and following missions, but also vertical. And another thing that's quite important to mention is the fact that all the flights that you're doing with UgCS, they are recorded locally on your computer. And so then at a later time, you're able to replay the telemetry from those flights. So we often get questions about drone connection. So how are the drones connected? So typically with most DJI drones, you just connect them by installing our UgCS for DJI app on your Android device or DJI smart controller. And then you just need to have the computer and the smart controller or Android device on the same network. And then the drone will appear in UgCS. Keep in mind here that the same network, it doesn't mean it needs to have internet. That's not the case. You can also, if you're in the field somewhere with no internet connectivity, it's okay to just have some local network as long as both devices can connect to one another. No internet connection is required. Alternatively, with some other drones, mainly non-DJI drones, you can connect to them via radio data links. So just plug in the radio over USB and then the drone will also appear. This is mostly the case with PX4 or Autopilot-based drones. Similarly, you can also connect to drones through Wi-Fi, so TCP or UDP protocols, as well as now actually with the release of new version of UgCS, we added the possibility to export routes directly to DJI Pilot 2. So let's say if you have some route planned, for example, for Mavic 3 Enterprise or DJI M30 or M300 drones. So these are currently the three drones that support that are supported in DJI Pilot 2. So you can actually create a route in UgCS and then export it directly as a KMZ file into DJI Pilot 2. So then kind of going further, as far as the flight planning tools go, what do you have in your toolset? So for simple flight planning, you have things such as waypoints, circle, and as well as perimeter. So these are basic tools I'm sure most of you are familiar with. And then next, moving on to area flight planning tools, we have the area scan, in which you typically specify the flight altitude manually. So let's say you if you say it's 15 meters, then you just enter 15 meter altitude in the area scan, as well as you typically provide the side distance manually as well. Then next is for the gram tree. For the gram tree, you can actually see here in this small screenshot on the side. So there you select what camera you have on your drone, you select the desired gram resolution, overlaps, and then based on these values, the software determines what should be the optimal flight height to achieve the desired resolution that you have over here. And then also we have the LiDAR area where you again specify the exact height, how high you need to fly, you specify the field of view of the sensor as well as other parameters. And then the LiDAR area is calculated along with adjustable corner radiuses, along with loop turns, which are specific to the LiDAR toolset. For the corridor mapping, we have the standard corridor, which is quite similar to photogrammetry, except that it's like a linear flight, where you also put approximating points. You specify the width of the corridor, and then the flight is calculated accordingly. So this can be a single line in a single direction. This can be a flight there and back, and so forth. Then also, of course, we have LiDAR corridor, which again is in many ways similar to the LiDAR area, except it's a linear flight rather than an area scan type of flight. And then also, like I mentioned before, we have the vertical scan feature, allowing you to scan the facades of buildings, of arch dams, and any other structures, such as, for example, telecommunication towers. To each of those flight planning tools, you can actually add different actions. So actually here you can see that for the photogrammetry tool, we currently have the set camera attitude action added, which changes the camera tilt 90 degrees downwards. And then below that, we have the set camera by distance action, which automatically calculates how often should the shots be taken in order to maintain this set forward and side overlap values. So here you can use either set camera by distance, or alternatively, you can also use set camera by time that the UgCS offers. So then going further for file import and export. So what possibilities do you have here? So you can create your flight plans from KML and CSV files, like I mentioned, or JSON. So JSON is the format which UgCS uses for flight import and export. So for example, if you have in your company multiple drone pilots and they need to share routes or flight plans with in between them, then they can simply use the JSON export feature and then easily share routes or whole missions containing multiple routes like that. Next is you can also, like I mentioned previously, you can import digital elevation, digital surface models, as well as map overlays from GeoTIFF files. So this would be the .tif extension. 3D models are imported from KMZ files to the objects and overlays. These are imported from KML, and also actually can import placemarks from KML files. And then I told you already that all the telemetry, all the flights are basically recorded in the telemetry player. And so if you need to share those telemetry flights or maybe save them in some other database, then you can export them as .tlm files. And then the route export is done in JSON. This can also be done to KML. In case you maybe need to review some of the routes in some other software, such as some GIST software, maybe fly with normal DJI Pilot or Auto Explorer. And then additionally, this is the new feature that I mentioned previously. So now you can export the routes together with all of the actions, all the parameters. You can export them to DJI Pilot 2. So this exports to KMZ WPML files, and then you can already import it directly into DJI Pilot, which also means that when you're in the field, if you need to quickly modify a route, you can do that. I know this slide maybe looks a bit complicated, but just I wanted to quickly mention is that UgCS architecture is modular. So in case you, for example, need to deploy the server somewhere in the cloud, then you can easily do that. And so, so from the typical client interface that you saw before, you can connect to the cloud server. And so this means also that actually pilots from the field with UgCS Enterprise, they can connect to the cloud server without the need to have the laptop with all the routes with them in the field. So what I also kind of briefly mentioned is that we recently released a new version of UgCS. So this is version 4.12. And in this new version, we have support for recently released DJI drones, so the Mavic 3 Enterprise, as well as Matrix 13. This also includes the thermal models, of course. So this is kind of how the export window looks like. So if you go typically here to root, and then export, then you're presented with this window. And so here you can select to either export the route to a JSON format, export the route to KML, as well as export this to DJI Pilot 2, allowing you to fly all of the routes from the native software if that's what you prefer. Yep, so among this, other some key features you have is we also now implemented the corridor splitting, as well as the ability to set vertical line spacing in meters. So these are the features of the new version of UgCS. And so then going further, I'd like to mention a bit about the license options, which you have, which already Jonathan briefly touched upon. So you have basically three different versions, three different licenses of UgCS. So you have the Pro, Expert, as well as Enterprise version. So the Pro version, this is the base version of UgCS. This includes most of the features that you would need. So you can plan your photogrammetry, flights, vertical inspections, and so forth. Then moving onwards to Expert license, the Expert license to that adds the capability to plan surveys for LiDAR. So planning LiDAR area scans, as well as LiDAR corridors. So all of this already becomes available in UgCS Expert. And there, of course, also for LiDAR, you have the IMU calibration patterns. So you're able to automatically add them within the route. So the IMU of the LiDAR is calibrated automatically. And once you have it all set up, all that's left for you to do is just launch the drone, see it do the calibration, and then start collecting LiDAR data. And then with UgCS Enterprise, here you get some exciting features. So you get the ability to stream video. You get, of course, the aforementioned LiDAR feature. So you get all the LiDAR surveys as well. And then in addition to that, you also get the ability to have distributed installations. So you can have different parts of the software deployed in different places. You can use cloud installation here as well. So yeah, the Enterprise is kind of the fullest of all of these licenses, and it contains all the previous all of the features of the previously mentioned licenses as well. And yeah, so if you want to find out more about them, you can also, of course, always head out to shop UgCS.com and yeah, read more about them and yeah, see what can we offer. Some other products which we have is we have UgCS Commander. So the Commander can be used in cases when you need to deploy multiple drones simultaneously. So here you can see the telemetry from all of them at the same time, as well as you can do things such as route upload to multiple drones simultaneously, as well as launching drones at the same time. And yeah, so main thing is here monitoring. So of course, one of the main features of this is that you're able to have multiple drones scan a large area at the same time, and you can monitor all of them together. Because typically you would need to, without the commander, you'd need to switch between the drones to see the data on all of them. So how are the drones doing? So the commander kind of takes that away, and so gives you the assurance that you can know what's happening with every drone at the same time. And in addition to that, we also have UgCS Mapper. So the Mapper is a quick and easy solution for doing in-field processing. So you can get your maps and elevation. One case where I can mention where the Mapper came in very handy is some years ago, we were in Greenland for an expedition with UgCS Integrated Systems, also with our CTO, Alexei. And we were basically looking for a lost airplane in the middle of nowhere in Greenland. We just were from a helicopter. We had to step out onto the ice, camp there for about a week. And yeah, so then we did catch the map and the elevation for offline use before that. But we simply realized that the terrain there changes quite a lot because, you know, the snow constantly melts and then snows again and so on. So in order to be able to plan our flights according to relevant and up-to-date maps, what we did is we had to strap a GoPro to the M600 because our Phantom drone failed for some reason. And yeah, so then basically we planned a mission for the M600 with UgCS, flew it. And then after that, we were able to just process all the data, create the map with the mapper, and then import it directly into UgCS and use it for doing further flight planning. So in that case, it was very useful for us. And so also if you're more interested in the mapper, then you can also find it on our site, shop.ugcs.com. And yep, I think then from my presentation, that's it. I'm also prepared to answer any questions if they come up in the Q&A section. So yep, then I pass the torch back to you, Jonathan and Chris.
Thanks very much. Thanks very much. Yeah, that was a good overview, Chris. So thanks very much for that. And I think it sets us up nicely for Chris Marshall to actually just to give a give a perspective from a pilot's perspective and somebody that actually teaches UgCS as well. So yeah, Chris, if you're okay, over to you.
That's great. Thanks, Jonathan. So I'm Chris Marshall. So I'm a director and chief instructor of Airbone Platforms UK in Peterborough. So we're a CAA RAE. This presentation is essentially an end user perspective on our operation of this flight control software. So my background, so 15 years experience, basically as a developing QHSE systems as a manager for data capture projects in civil engineering, oil and gas, utilities and rail and construction. I'm a Lloyd's Register qualified QHSE auditor and NEBOSH quality, basically qualified risk assessor. We started flying and using UgCS kind of in 2014-15. We've logged over 3,000 hours of UgCS connected missions. So a bit about Airbone Platforms as well. So Airbone was started in 2015 and was basically the 1611th registered UK kind of PFCO. We've got essentially 7 years of operation, completing survey and mapping projects in many different sectors. Currently operating the kind of M300, N600 on regularly. However, we do operate many different kind of airframes. Basically, and then, you know, we operate the associated payloads, you know, for those as well in the specific category in the UK. So we regularly complete kind of RGB, of course, kind of daylight, multispectral, thermal and magnetic surveys on behalf of our clients. And we started our training arm in 2017 and have trained thousands of UAS pilots in the UK, helping them achieve, again, before the change, permission for commercial operations, and then subsequently the new GVC competency and operational authorizations for their organizations. We released the first kind of online permission for commercial operations course in 2017. And again, our kind of day-to-day as well as the kind of operation side is, you know, assisting many blue chip companies to achieve success with UAS, you know, including the use of UgCS. So the types of operation that where we use UgCS, we operate a lot in the agricultural sector, producing multispectral imagery and imaging and kind of creation of index maps in agriculture. Also the thermal imaging and the creation of thermal maps for things like heat loss, building surveys, 3D thermal 3D modeling, and the mapping and fault detection in solar arrays. Then also in a standard RGB imaging for the creation of kind of RGB maps, you know, just daylight maps for many, many different sectors. In fact, this is probably the majority of the work that we conduct. We also conduct very large scale LiDAR and photogrammetry projects like the one shown there. So this statement, okay, across all types of operation, over thousands of hours of automated flight, UgCS has performed flawlessly, allowing us to deliver our services efficiently. So it's a very, very easy one for me to say this, really, because we've had so much experience using it, and it's never let us down. It's without doubt a great tool. So there's many providers of flight automation software, many of which I'm sure you'll be aware of. I'm not going to mention any names because I don't think that's right, but some even bundle solutions with hardware. So why do we want to use UgCS? So these are really the key areas that we see at the moment. This isn't an exhaustive list, however. So the ability for us to really have a standardized approach in our operations, UgCS is key in this. And I'm going to go and explain more in each of these areas, you know, further on in the presentation. So the computer-based graphical user interface is absolutely vital to us. The project repeatability allows us to kind of get continuity in the data capture projects that we run. The usability and the reliability, the reactive support of the UgCS support team when it's needed. And, you know, it is the best in its class solution. So as far as the standardized approach to the data collection, Because of the map-based system and because it, we can actually plan using the software in the office, it's easier, far more easier for us to actually plan and share data with our clients and really kind of get off to the right start. So it allows us to create a much more streamlined, standardized process, which then can be outsourced to contractors. So the initial flight by internal staff, and then throughout the project lifecycle, if we need to go back into locations, we can then refly exactly on those locations. The intuitive interface reduces the learning curve when training new pilots, which is massively important. So it just works. Every element seems to be exactly in the right place. So everything in its right place. The integration with Google Earth Key Markup Language KML files basically allows our clients to specify survey locations. So the onus is on them to verify, where they want surveying, and then us to review and check. And that is then uploaded into UgCS. Avoids, the pitfall of a rework of us not actually hitting the right location on any surveys. So the computer-based GUI, basically, it's the only UAS flight planning software with this level of infield functionality. It's an easy, clear interface for pilots to monitor the flight progress in field and basically avoid any possible, the missing strip error where parts of the data set aren't actually there after battery changes. And it does, that can happen. If you're trying to view the flight on a very small screen, like an app. Interface alone, reduces infield errors without a doubt. And of course allows us to avoid costly rework. So I've mentioned a bit earlier about the repeatability. So much of our work involves repeat flights after a certain time, along a project's lifecycle, and even sometimes, once that's built as well. So mission export allows for consistent creation of the standardized deliverable, and it every flight it allows us to match previous versions and provide continuity of data to our clients, whoever completes the flight. So if it's our internal staff, then we know that if we send the flight plan off to a contractor, then exactly the same flight will be conducted. So that, of course, allows for great scalability. So usability and reliability as well. So it just works. So when, where you need it to. This is an important one. In 7 years, we've tried and tested all current automation solutions, and there's always been one winner. We've tested other ones, and to say that, I'm sure some of them have performed adequately, but none to the same level, I would say. So think really careful about the solution you choose, because if you can't rely on it 100%, then your reputation's at stake. You need to know that when you're in front of your client, it's going to do exactly what it says on the tin, avoiding embarrassment. The last thing you want is to be having to field support calls when your client's sitting there watching his watch. It's not a good look. In our own experience, basically with other solutions, you're not going to get the same reliability. Completing on-site changes or any changes on-site via an app, it's just not the same. If you do that, then you're more likely to add error in the field on a small app rather than actually on a laptop. Any in-field additions to any routes or tweaks are actually very easily created when you're out in the field. Another really key one here is a reactive support. So it's rarely needed, but when it is needed, the support is prompt and on point. And we've had experience with other providers, again, not mentioning any names, where we've had to wait 3 days for an answer. Now, 3 days in the field is a medium-sized to large-scale project. So that, it has to be one of the really key elements, this really, having that support, when you need it. It's real-time support in the field as well, if required, which is invaluable. And our experience with many other providers is, you know, it has been lacking in this area, but not with UgCS. So if you go down this route, you're getting a best in its class solution. It's tried and tested over many operations in the field over many years, designed from the top down with the end user in mind. And you know, no other solution provides the same level of functionality as UgCS. And I pretty much stand by that. And as a project-driven organization, Airbone Platforms, we really wouldn't be without it. So a little bit more about Airbone. I mean, we can assist you and your kind of team to achieve CAA certification. That's something that we do, providing the kind of GBC and kind of A2 CFC qualifications. We can assist kind of moving forward as well for you to develop your own drone programs and then moving forward after that into your annual CAA operational authorization renewals. With basically the Airbone team, we've got extensive knowledge on how to implement corporate drone programs across many different sectors. So, you know, we can help in that area. So we can show you how to leverage the tools available, such as UgCS, to provide value to your clients and avoid the many, many pitfalls that there are of kind of going it alone. So if you'd like any more information, then scan the QR and get in touch or contact us on the number below or the email. You know, we'd love to help. Thanks very much.
Great, thanks very much, Chris. That was really good, and I think it like I said before, it's important to get that different perspective, that real perspective from a user of UgCS, because you can't be getting a first hand account of what it's like to actually use the software when you're out there trying to do a project and you really need something that's going to deliver. So that was really good. So that kind of just to remind everybody that there is a poll open. If you can spare some time just to have a go at that poll, that'd be great. And also a very open secret, as JBUAS is a UK reseller and if I would say strategic partner to SPH Engineering or UgCS in the UK, software and sensor systems can be purchased at discounted rates over those list prices you see within the shop. Within the UgCS shop. So, you know, just bear that in mind that, we can start a relationship and we can offer something that over and above which you'd get online. So, yeah, it's always worth having a chat with us about what we can actually provide in regards to, the software itself, whether you're interested in starting out with UgCS Pro, whether you're interested more in the LiDAR tool set, which I'm aware, Chris, you use a lot, and you're very, you're praised quite a lot as well, in terms of the expert and that LiDAR tool set, or indeed the enterprise. Maybe your video streaming is something that'd be very useful to you if you've got multiple drones, multiple pilots. Come and see us, and we can certainly have a discussion. So in regards to Q&A, thanks everyone, thanks Chris Ups and Chris again. I thought that was really good. So in regards to Q&A, one of the questions that we've got is, can Chris Ups, could you just discuss a little bit more about corridor splitting?
Sure. So basically corridor splitting works in the following way. So currently we have implemented very simply. So when you construct a corridor, it's constructed using approximating points. And so then essentially to split the corridor, you can click on any of these approximating points, right click, and then just select the split option. And so then from there, the corridor will be split into two parts, and then you can already work separately with each of the part as a separate route. If you'd like, I can also actually show this in the software, or if not, we can move to the next question.
Yeah. Okay. And Chris Marshall, there's a question for you about expert.
Okay.
So I'm pointing at you because I know that you've used it. So it's essentially, you know, what are the main benefits of using Expert for and the LiDAR toolset?
Well, I mean, the main benefits are the calibration, you know, the loop terms and calibration, and the over and above what I've said, you know, the usability. It's just far better than anything out there. I mean, we've tried using app-based solutions. I'm not gonna, again, not naming any names, but the UgCS is just far, far kind of superior. But yeah, I mean, the ability to use many different payloads as well, and really lock in exact settings and exact flight routines in order not to kind of buffer the IMUs. Yeah, so there's nothing like it, really.
Great, okay. There's a question for you, Kristaps, so I think you're probably best to answer it, and that is, apart from video streaming, enterprise, is there a quick overview of enterprise you can give and why it would benefit, what kind of company it would benefit?
Suppose I'd say that for the enterprise, we see as two kind of main end customers. One would be simply people who need to make sure that they are getting the video feed from the drone when they are in the field. This can be as simple as, you know, a team of multiple people who, for example, maybe they are heading out on some search and rescue mission with drones, and they're flying, let's say, some 3-4 drones at the same time. And, you know, the pilots might be, let's say, a bit further away from the main command center, or they might be simply out of the, let's say, some tent if that's set up to monitor the drones. And then the main operator in the office or in the command tent has to see the live video from the drones. So that would be one case of the enterprise. Another one would be for larger companies employing more pilots. What they can do with the enterprise is that they can actually deploy UgCS server in the cloud. And so this means basically you can have one person sitting, again, in the main control room planning all the flights for the pilots. And then the pilots simply need to go to the field on a certain day, and then they can already connect to the server remotely without the need to have the laptop, without the need to have to modify the mission. The mission is already all set up for them. All they need to do is open up the mission file. They will be able to connect to the server from their mobile device or DJI smart controller, grab the route, upload to the drone, and fly. And so then also during the flight, all the telemetry and everything is saved in the main server. So yeah, basically, if you have more pilots, then enterprise solutions kind of what you would be after.
Another one for you, Kristaps, is in regards to how you set up UgCS Pro for use for a first timer. I'm guessing it's to do with you'd need the DJI for UgCS on an app. And
yeah, so here it really depends on what drone you're using. I'll say that the setup of UgCS, it's the same for all licenses except enterprise, where it's a bit more complicated. But so Expert and Pro setup, it's basically identical. So you just do the installation. You can always grab the software from our site. In fact, you can also download it and test it with the emulator drone, even if you don't yet have a license. Maybe, you know, you kind of want to evaluate it, see how the flight planning is. You can actually download it even today. Just go to gcs.com, download section, download the software, install it, and then already once you get your Pro license, Pro or Expert, then just enter the activation code. And then as far as connecting it to a drone, then of course you need to connect to a DJI drone, you need UgCS for DJI app. Here it differs between what drones you have. If you're using maybe something like a DJI Mavic 2 or Phantom 4, then you'd need to get download the app from Google Play Store. But if you are using it on the smart controller, as in the case of the M300, so currently the M300 is our most popular platform, about 30% of users, that's our estimate, are using it. So then in that case, you just download the APK file directly from our site, put it on the smart controller, install the app, and then the rest is the same. You just connect both devices on the same network, your drone appears, and then you're able to plan your missions.
Kristaps, one for you. Does UgCS work with non-DJI drones?
Yeah, it does work. So like I mentioned in my presentation, you can also use non-DJI drones. One example of such would be the FreeFly Alta X drone. Also now actually we're testing the FreeFly Astro drone. So we are planning on also adding this to our list of supported drones. This would be probably the closest you would have to an M300 from non-DJI drones. And then others as well. So basically almost any Mavlink compatible drone with PX4 or autopilot firmware, you can use that with UgCS.
Okay, so that's pretty much the questions answered. So I mean that's we're not far from time anyway. So I just want to thank everybody for coming on the call. I hope people the webinar. I hope people have learned about UgCS Pro and also that the first-hand account from Chris at Airbone Platforms has been useful. Like I said, you know, please reach out if you're interested in the software or indeed the integrated sensors. Like I said at the start of my little piece, you know, the integrated systems, the sensor systems rely on the UgCS Pro Expert or Enterprise for its mission planning. So, you know, we there's certainly a conversation to be had, and please come, you know, get in touch. But anyway, you know, I just want to thank everybody. Chris, Marshall, thanks very much for your time. And Chris,
thanks, Jonathan. Thanks for having me.
Thank you very much for your time.
Yep, thank you, Jonathan.
Thanks very much, everybody.
Cheers.
Thank you, Glenn.
Yep, cheers.
Thank you. Bye.